Hello? Is anyone there? What am I to do? I'm all alone. Pooh, where are you? It's me, Piglet.
Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. Now, if you remember last time, we got a new torn page. This is that new torn page. You can find it in the top right corner of the Winnie the Pooh book. Now we need to catch Piglet, but in order to do it, you actually have to go around and catch it from behind. So, in case you happen to be dumb and exploring the area like I did and run into him from the front, he won't come out until you leave the page and come back. So, you need to leave the page, come back, if you did what I just did. Anyway, sorry for the non-uploading period, viewers. I'm going to be leaving Florida soon. I'm staying with my parents for the time being. But I'm going to be going back to Georgia within a week or so here. And there's a few things that have been going on. Namely, there's also a hurricane that they announced would be coming on the way. But besides that, I've been packing and doing other things, so, you know, the uploads are going to be a little bit slow just for a little while, viewers, but it'll pick back up eventually. You know, it'll go back up to a moderate pace of what I had it before. I do want to try and upload as much as I can.
Oh dear, I was never mind, I'm sorry.
Don't be scared. You're looking for Pooh, right?
You know Pooh. Oh, you see, I have something for him. I have to take it to Pooh right away. Oh, Pooh!
Oh, I believe I smell a delicious something. A something like honey.
Pooh!
Hello, Piglet. How have you been?
Oh, I'm so glad to see you. I thought you'd gone away. I brought what you asked for.
Thank you, Piglet. Now I can finally have some honey.
Really? But how?
I shall hold on to the balloon and fly like a bee up the honey tree, see?
What if you take their honey? Won't the bees be angry?
Oh.
Yes, so we have a new mini game. That's right. It's pretty straightforward if you've been following along with the cutscene. Pooh, I guess as we should call him, Pooh will fly up into the tree and collect honey from certain spots in the tree, which is a little strange considering the honey should actually be in the combs with the bees, but anyway, I'm not going to question logic here. And you are to protect Pooh from the bees. The bees will try to attack the balloon, popping the balloon, which will essentially send Pooh towards the ground, where he will have to start his climb up the tree all over again, because, you know, he is no regular Pooh Bear. He must climb a tree with a balloon. So, yeah. And he has an unlimited supply, so don't worry, there aren't, like, pop three times and you lose automatically, or anything like that. Anyway, so one of the things is with this game, you get a command called Rush. Now what Rush does is, it basically rushes you up the tree. That's my dog. My door's open. That's why she sounds louder. Anyway, you basically rush up the tree, and I'm going to scream at that dog in just like a second. It will rush up the tree for you. I'm repeating this like 5 times, so you can get to poo quicker. See, like I fell here. You have to fall all the way to the ground though, which sucks. And it'll auto jump you up to where poo is. Now, in order to beat this minigame, I did air quotations there. You need to get Pooh's honey meter thing up there over 100. Every minigame here, if you get it over a certain amount of points or whatever, if you beat it within a certain time limit, by the time you reach the end of the Pooh's adventure, you get a very special prize. Now, every time you kill a thing of bees, Pooh's honey meter goes up by 10. So it's a good idea to kill the bees. That's the main way you'll be boosting Pooh's honey meter. See, it went up to 48, it's at 50. But every time Pooh's balloon gets popped by the bees, basically you make it go down by 10. So once you get him up here, usually it's pretty easy to keep the bees away from him. But I kind of missed there, and I was like, well, that sucked. I don't know what the perfect score could be. I think you might be able to get it like over 200 if you can even let it go that high, if the game doesn't even end before then. But yeah, I mean, pretty much this is a very simple mini game. There's nothing too hard to it, unless you're just rusty like me and inarticulate and can't seem to hit the bees when you goddamn want to, viewers. Anyway, sorry. Makes me furious. I just want to hit the bees. Oh, and that happens. When that happens, viewers, don't even get me started when it puts you up on a higher level and you have to drop down just to hit this the stupid bees. Oh, good lord. So basically, the only way you can lose this game is if you never hit the bees. Because if you never hit the bees, not even once, and Pooh's balloon is always getting popped, then he'll always be losing honey more than he can get it. So you basically just need to make sure you get to him before the bees do, like there. Hit them, my dog, Cindy! My dog. Anyway, this is not Legend of Zelda! This is a wrong Let's Play! Cindy!
It is rather funny what I will do for honey.
My dog, driving me nuts. She actually got a haircut today, so it's crazy. Anyway. There's a car passing by. Please don't go bark at it. Anyway, so for beating that minigame, we got a nature spark, in case you didn't notice. Cindy, do not come in my room. You know you're not allowed in rooms. Man, I'm spending more time talking to the dog than narrating. Anyway, so for beating that game, we got a one of those gems. And, now we can talk to, what is this thing called? The Fairy Godmother, I believe it is. And, she'll give us a new summon. Bambi! Some consider this to be the most overpowered summon for grinding purposes in the game. I will demonstrate this later, viewers, so don't worry. Anyway, so now that we've finished Winnie the Pooh, the rest of what we have to do is very simple. We now have to go and do all of the green Trinity Marks that we have not been able to collect as of yet. I believe there's a total of three or four maybe. There's four. Four or so. Three? Four. You know what? I can't remember, viewers, and I'm all sniffly, if you can't tell. I slept without a blanket last night. And my allergies are also going crazy, so if I take a Zyrtec, I'd probably be okay. So yeah. Anyway, we need to do two things here. One, we need to collect this green trinity. And two, come on, there you go. And two, we need to extinguish the flames on the torches. Remember last time we tried and our blizzard spell just wasn't strong enough? Well, now that our blizzard spell has been upgraded to Blizzara, it is more than strong enough. So, let's just go around the area here, targeting these, and being a loser, and going into the magic thing, because I don't want to pause, viewers, you know, and put it on my thing when I can just go to magic and select it. You only need to cast it once, by the way, so don't worry about it. By the way, viewers, excuse me, if you've been playing along with me, and you've been saying, man, I sure use magic a lot and seem to run out very quickly, I wish I had more magic, don't worry. I'm going to be changing Sora's setup so he's going to be more of a magic user soon. So keep that in mind, viewers, because it's basically going to change the way I play with Sora. Not a whole lot, but enough so where I will be explaining how and why I have him set up the way I do. Essentially, I think I have him with Sonic Thrust right now. Yeah, I'm not going to be using that too much anymore. Basically, it's once we get Strike Raid, viewers, I don't know if I would call saying we're going to get that a spoiler, but eventually we will get that. It's like the signature move of Kingdom Hearts practically now. But once we get that move, we're going to be using that a lot, not a lot more. Actually, I haven't even used it once, I think, yet. I don't even know if I have it equipped right now. But we're going to be using that instead of Sonic Thrust. Mostly because Sonic Thrust, you have to be on an even plane in order to use that. While Strike Raid, you can throw that anywhere and hit anyone. So it is a far superior move to Sonic Thrust, viewers. And yeah, that's one of the things. I'm gonna be trying to explain setups for like multiple people. You know, if you want to use magic, that's the way I'm going. So that's how I'm gonna have it set up. If you want to use pure melee abilities, you know, or pure just Keyblade swinging Sora, I'll tell you how to set yourself up for that too, viewers, don't worry. But as of right now, let's not worry about it, because we're doing pretty good. Viewers, you know, we're okay, you know. Anyway. So, you want to shrink down the size here, because if you remember, which you might not, there's a bunch of things here, but that's not why I'm telling you to remember. If you remember, in the stove, there's another green trinity mark. Oh, I'm sorry, viewers, my nose is killing me. I can't believe I woke up with a stuffy nose. I haven't woken up with a stuffy nose in, like, well, actually, since I've come back down to Florida, I've woken up with a stuffy nose almost every day. And I took care of it. I blew my nose before I started recording this, but oh, just the allergies down here kick my butt. Like, in Georgia, I have no allergies. No allergies at all. But down here, it is like, no. It is just ridiculous. Anyway, so, you know, you might be asking, Kevin, why are you killing these things on screen? Well, I actually want to, like, show you guys, look how strong we've become, you know? We weren't here not too long ago, really, in the game, if you think about it. And, even Donald is hitting as hard as we used to, you know? And we kill things so much quicker. Yeah, that's really always a good way to, like, gauge how much stronger you've become, is just go back to the older worlds and just kill stuff. You know, I mean, I'm killing stuff in, like, one hit of my Keyblade swing now. It's crazy, viewers. Crazy. See? This is what I call appropriate leveling, viewers. Not overpowered. Not underpowered for where I should be going. You know, actually, where I'm going to be going after Aggro, I was a little underleveled, viewers, but because of the way I had my character set up, it wasn't a problem. And you'll see. You'll see. Actually, I don't change my setup after where I'm going. But you'll see, viewers. Normally, for where we go after Agrabah, I should be around level 30, but I think I went around like level 27, 28. But don't worry about it, because it's really, it doesn't make a big deal. Two levels don't make a big deal at all. Anyway, so, in here should be the last green trinity mark. And then, I think I'm going to call it an episode. And then we'll be heading towards the next place after Agrabah in the next episode, viewers. So yeah. I don't even know what I'm saying. Yeah. This one, I hate this green training mark. One, because it's so hard to find it. That wasn't the right way to go. Two, because it's just like, it gives you nothing. A mythical shard and a bunch of health orbs? That would have been useful when we were here. Oh, don't fall in there. Yeah, I don't want to go through that stupid minigame again. That was annoying. Anyway, viewers, I'm going to call this an episode. All of you have a good day. I'm sorry for my dog barking and my nasal problems. And, goodbye. Goodbye, my viewers. Into space!